Hi, welcome to Harmony with Su-Lynn. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to use the advanced auto patch system and the peg hierarchy to rig a character. I'll demonstrate using the arm and leg. The asset you'll need is a simple character design in a neutral front pose that you've broken down into character parts. So let's start. Here's my character Cholula. To begin, you'll need to have broken down one side of an arm and leg. Check out my tutorial on character breakdown, as you'll need to know that before you get to this stage of rigging. And just as a gentle reminder, you'll need to draw outlines with the pencil tool. Drawing outlines must be drawn in the line art layer. Drawing fill colors must be painted in the color art layer. We use the advanced auto patch system to patch an articulation without having to do any line adjustment or color overlapping. You can draw your pieces with their complete lines overlapping, and the auto patch node will create a perfect articulation from it. The difference between using a simple auto patch node and the advanced auto patch system is that you can use Z depth and send pieces behind or in front without breaking the rig. With this articulation system, it will also create a fold illusion when the elbow is bent. Select all the arm pieces using the Select tool by clicking and dragging. Hold down Shift and Command together and hit P to add multiple pegs. Put the rotation points in. It's easiest to start with the articulation pieces, the elbow, wrist, and shoulder, so we can copy and paste the XY coordinates in the corresponding breakdown pieces. If we take the elbow, for example, select the piece, select Rotate, you might find it easier to disable, shortcut D, other drawings, to see the whole piece. Position accurately in the center. Now you can open up the properties of the elbow peg, open up the properties of the lower arm, copy the X value from the elbow, paste that in the X value of the lower arm, copy the Y value from the elbow, paste that in the Y value of the lower arm. Repeat this for the wrist and hand, shoulder and upper arm. You can also open up the properties panel if you prefer. We'll start with rigging the elbow. For this, you'll need a lot of space, so spread out your nodes and use backdrops to contain a group of nodes together. Hit Return key to get the node library up and put in the first two letters of the required node. We'll need a line art, color art, and a composite node. Attach the line art and color art to the drawing of the elbow and add them to a new composite that connects to the main composite. Disconnect the original connector. Select the line art and attach a cutter node. You'll need an auto patch node. Attach that to the upper arm. Note that you do not attach the auto patch node to the upper arm main connector, but take another connector from the upper arm drawing node to attach the auto patch. The auto patch is then connected to the cutter node's left input mat port. And this is the auto patch system. Attach an auto patch node to the lower arm. As it only has one input port, you will need a bitmap composite when you have multiple connections. And connect it to the elbow cutter. You can group, shortcut Command G, all the nodes for the auto patch system so it can be duplicated and reused. You can simply duplicate the group and attach it, but I'll show you how to build the system again on the wrist articulation. We'll need a line art, color art, and a composite. Attach a cutter node. Connect the auto patch node to the hand and connect that to the mat port of the cutter of the wrist. This will also share the cutter's mat port with the lower arm. As it only has one input port, you will need to use a composite. Add the auto patch system to the shoulder articulation joint. Take a connector from the auto patch node of the upper arm and connect it. Now you have rigged using the auto patch system, let's take a look at the peg hierarchy. Pegs are mainly used to control a series of drawing layers. Remember to name your pegs as you go along. Above the pegs of the hand and wrist, add one peg to connect them together, Command P. We want the wrist and hand to be controlled as one unit, so they are connected by one single peg at the top, but they can still have separate pegs to be controlled individually. At the rotation point, you can copy and paste coordinates from the wrist peg. Let's do the same for the lower arm and elbow. You can use waypoints, select the waypoint, hold Option, and select the node you want to connect. Repeat for the upper arm and shoulder. We can add another peg above the lower arm hierarchy so the lower arm and hand move as one. At the top of the arm hierarchy is the master arm peg that connects the lower arm and upper arm pegs. Now for the fun bit. Let's test the arm rig by posing the arm in front of the body. Note the fold to the arm that naturally occurs with this breakdown method. We can test the rig by sending the lower arm behind the body. Select the peg for the lower arm, make sure you're in the camera view, hold Option and hit the up arrow for a shortcut, or select coordinate from window and toolbars and put in a minus value in the Z position. Shortcut R to reset pegs. Let's continue with the leg rig. We'll assume you've already watched the character breakdown tutorial. Select all the drawings, Shift and Command and P to add pegs. The foot, ankle, lower leg, knee, upper arm, and hip. Add the rotation point using the same method as the arm. Start with the knee, ankle, and hip joints, and then copy and paste XY values into corresponding pegs for the breakdown pieces. Let's apply the advanced auto patch system, or you can copy the system group from the arm auto patch system and paste it here. I'll repeat the auto patch system. We need a line art, color art, and a composite node. Attach the line art and color art to the drawing of the elbow and add them to a new composite that connects to the main composite. Disconnect the original connector. Select the line art and attach a cutter node. Get an auto patch from the node library. The auto patch is then connected to the cutter node's left input mat port. Attach one each to the upper leg and another to the lower leg. As the cutter has only one input port, you'll need a composite so they share it. Repeat the system for the ankle and hip, attaching the auto patch for the foot, lower leg, upper leg, and hip. Above the pegs of the foot and ankle, add one peg to connect them. We want the foot and ankle to be controlled as one unit, so they are connected by one single peg at the top, but they can still have separate pegs to be controlled individually. Let's do the same for the lower leg and knee. And the upper leg and hip. We can add another peg above the foot and lower leg hierarchy, so the lower leg and foot move as one. At the top of the hierarchy is the master leg peg that connects the lower leg and upper leg pegs. Let's test the rig by posing the front leg bent across the back leg. Make sure you're in the camera view, hold Option and hit the up arrow. Notice the lovely fold illusion on the leg when it bends. And that's it for the advanced auto patch system and peg hierarchy. In the next tutorial, we'll cover two-point constraints and deformers for this rig. In the meantime, you might like to check out my tutorial on eyelid deformers. Thanks for watching. See you next time!